بأجزائه والباقس بتاعته اللي هي الجزئيات والكلمة الجزئية أو بيت الأب الأمريكية في الحرب الفلسطينية انترنالي بارت أوف ذا تيك كولكتنج فيديوز The neutron has a separate embryological origin from the collecting tubules and the collecting ducts. It has to be clear. So the parts of the neutron are renal corpuscle, proximal convoluted tubule, lobe of Hell, and the distal convoluted tubule, full stop. But the collecting tubules and the collecting ducts have a different embryological origin. There is something which is called uriniferous tubule. When you read uriniferous tubule, it means the nephron together with its collecting tubule. Full stop. Okay? It's present actually in the PowerPoint slide. Collecting tubules and the collecting ducts, which have a different embryological origin from the nephron, they are long, they are three regions. The part of the collecting tubules or ducts present in the cortex, in which part of the cortex? Medullary rays. Medullary rays. And then, after the medullary rays in the cortex, they go down to the medulla. Starting by a collecting tubule which receive branches from the different nephrons. The group of branches which deliver urine into a one collecting tubule in the middle of medullary vein forms a kidney lobule. So the kidney lobe is forming of a pyramid together with the cortical part overlying. While the kidney lobule it is forming of medullary vein in the center. In the medullary vein, there is a collecting tubule. The collecting tubule gets urine from different nephrons. The group of nephrons delivering urine into collecting tubule in the middle of the medullary vein forms a kidney lobule. Is it clear? Again, imagine. Okay, this is a lobe. In the lobe and the cortical medullary junction, there are medullary veins. This is my hand is a lobe. This is the cortical part and this is the medullary part. These are medullary veins. In medullary veins, you will see collecting tubules which continue down to collecting ducts. The collecting tubule gets urine from a group of nephrons. The group of nephrons, together with the central medullary vein and the collecting tubule, form a lobule. So, this lobe is forming of lobules. Clear or not clear? Clear. Okay, collecting tubules and to stop at here. This is the most important in this slide. The collecting tubules drain urine into collecting ducts. The collecting ducts are larger in diameter than the collecting tubules. Also, the epithelium differ. In the collecting tubules, it's pubical epithelium. In the collecting ducts, it's columnar epithelium. At the apex of the pyramid, the papillary or the collecting tubule It can be called Zavat Ovili. So Zavat Ovili is just a collected duct at the terminal part of the Amitabha impairment. It is the widest collecting tubule, lying divine to lumbar epithelia. Forming of fine, union of several medullary collecting tubules. Large in diameter, not important in diameter. They open at the area tribrosa of the hind and papilla. What is the area tribrosa? This is the parent. Open into its apex here, the collecting duct. The opening of each collecting duct forms a hole. So the apex contains many openings. Each opening is an opening for a collecting duct. So this area appears perforated, have openings. The openings of collecting duct. So we call it area tribrosa, perforated area, perforated by openings of collecting ducts. Like with tortular epithelial cells. What's the function of collecting tubules and collecting ducts? What is the function of collecting tubules? Conduct urine, concentration of urine by water absorption, which is controlled by antidiuretic hormone secreted by pars nervosa of the pituitary gland. It concentrates urine and makes the urine hypertonic. Hypertonic. So the urine coming out through the collecting tubules and coming back is hypertonic. Concentrated hypertonic urine. These are two collecting tubules. As they go down, the epithelium gradually enlarges until it changes to simple columnar epithelium. As you see, the cells, because the medulla around it, they are cuboid. The cytoplasm is bare because the activity is less than the other parts. The parts of the nephron. And these are the clean cell boundaries. No brush border, no basal membrane infoldings or ion transport sites. Renal interstitia. What do we mean by renal interstitia? It is the connective tissue present in the cortex and in the medulla. The connective tissue in the kidney is minimal. It's very small, but in the medulla is larger than in the cortex. Why? It contains fibroblast-like cells. Fibroblast-like cells, which are secretory cells. They secrete a substance called medullary bean, which is anti-hypertensive. Renal interstitia in the cortex, it is dispersed in small amounts. In the medulla, it is more extensive, rich in fibroblast-like cells. These cells are called the medullary interstitial cells. The fibroblast-like cells are called the medullary interstitial cells, which are rich with no problem. Okay, this is basically substances, prostaglandins and prostacyclins. But what's important for me is medullary bean. Do the kidney have another role in controlling the blood pressure? Through what? Renin. If a hypertension, through renin. Do the kidney can decrease the blood pressure? Yes, by a substance called medullary bean, which leads to vasodilatation. And after vasodilatation, decrease in the blood pressure. Hormone secreted by the kidney. Renin, secreted by the juxtaglomerular cells in the juxtaglomerular apparatus. Juxtaglomerular cells are present in the wall of afrenta anterior going to give the glomerulus for the renal corpuscle. The Zaxpar glomerular cells are modified smooth muscle cells in the media of arterior to be a secretory and not contractile. So they contain secretory granules. The content of secretory granules is renin. Secreted in response to decrease in the blood pressure. Decrease in the renal, in the blood flow in the afferent arteriole. Also, was stimulated by decrease in the ionic composition of distal convoluted tubules. Cells of macular density in distal convoluted tubule are osmoreceptors. Their cells give impulses to juxtaglomerular cells in the wall of afferent arteriole to secrete urine with the decrease in ionic concentration. Not only being secreted by the liver interstitial cells, erythroglutine. What is erythroglutine? Erythro from erythrocyte. Who stimulates the synthesis of red blood cells by the bone marrow? Erythroglutine. Forming where? Okay. In the kidney. Erythropoietine is forming in the kidney. By what? There are capillaries in the cornea. The capillaries are lined by endothelial cells. Do the endothelial cells here can be secretory? Yes. They secrete erythropoietin, which go to the bone marrow and stimulate the formation of red blood cells. Do the kidney is a sign of activation of vitamin D? Yes, it is a sign of activation of vitamin D. Okay, blood supply of the kidney. I will get a picture and speak. What is the type of renal artery? What do you mean by an endoartery? What do you mean by endoartery? Cartouche? Do you know arteries which have no anastomosis? Okay. The arteries usually anastomose together. Why? If the lumen is closed, or if this artery is closed, the anastomosis will go to its distal branches and the supply, the cells supplied by this artery. So the cells will not die. What is an endoartery? Endoartery has no anastomosis. If the endoartery is closed by a thrombus or bleed, nezif, the cells supplied by this artery will die. Where you can find the endoarteries? Free kidney, another site. Free lung, another site. Free heart, another site. Free brain. Now, the closure of the artery supplying an area in the kidney, in the heart, in the lung, in the brain, if its artery is in the artery, has no branches, no anastomosis, no anastomosis with other arteries. If the end artery is closed or bleed, yes, the area supplied, the cells in the area supplied will die, will degenerate. Is it clear? This is important to know what is the effect of emboli or thrombus or bleeding in an artery in the kidney or the heart, or the lung, or the brain. Now, what is the blood vessel which is supply the kidney? Renal artery develops from where? The aorta. The aorta. When it goes into the hilum of the kidney, or the medial wall of the kidney, or the entrance side of the kidney, the renal artery gives anterior and the posterior branches. These branches will give rise to interlobar arteries. How many lobes do we have in the kidney?
18.
Okay, 10 and up to 18. Between each renal lobe and the papillary part of renal lobes, interlobar arteries will arise or will enter. Okay? After the interlobar artery at the cortico medullary junction, each artery gives arcuate artery. These arcuate arteries will not communicate. So, because it is an endo artery, the arcuate arteries of the branches of interlobar at the corticomedullary junction are arcuate, parallel to the surface of the kidney, but at the corticomedullary junction. They will not communicate. What these arcuate arteries will give rise? The arcuate arteries will give rise to interlobular arteries. What is this? What is this? What is this? Hello? Medullary ray. The medullary ray, the connecting tubule in the medullary ray drains from nephrons in the tubule. So this is the tubule. The end, what is the name of arteries coming out from the arcuate arteries are called interlobular arteries. So we start by the renal artery, gives the anterior and the posterior branches to the pelvis of the kidney, and then enter to give interlobular arteries. Interlobular arteries at the corticomedullary junction will give arcuate arteries. Arcuate arteries will not communicate, but will give interlobular arteries. What the interlobular arteries will give rise? The interlobular arteries, this is the glomerulus, and this is the afferent arteriole. So interlobular arteries in the cortex, present in the cortex, will give rise to afferent arterioles, to nephrons inside the lobule. The afferent arteriole will give rise to the capillary plexus of the glomerulus. And the blood will go out from the glomerulus through or connected to four. The blood goes out through efferent arteriole. What the efferent arteriole will give rise?
Interlobular vein.
The efferent arteriole will give rise to a network of capillaries. The capillaries will surround the section of the proximal and the convoluted tubules to supply them. So we call it bentubular capillaries. Now, interlobular will give afferent. Afferent will give the glomerulus. Glomerulus gives the efferent arteriole. Efferent arteriole gives a plexus of capillaries, around the proximal and distal convoluted tibia in the cortex. So we call these capillaries vein tubular capillaries. What do their lining cells can secrete? Erythropoietin, formed by endothelial cells lining peritubular capillaries. Now, the peritubular capillaries will connect to four intertubular veins. بس على الاستوب اكيد سوري يعني دي صح بس هكملها بعد كده. طيب what is the end of the intertubular? Intertubular artery. It will end by capillaries dexter in the capsule of the kidney, connective tissue capsule in the kidney and the outer part of the cortex. What is about? The blood supply of the blood. Which is more rich? The cortical blood supply or the urinary blood supply? The cortical. It's more rich in blood supply. From where the blood supply of the medullary tissue will come? Do you know a priori recti? What are the a priori recti? What do you mean by a priori recti? Atrial is small artery. Recti is straight. Which will arise from arteriole recti. These are this color is light brown or something like that. The light color, the brown, is the arteriole recti. The arteriole recti will develop from the epithelial arteriole of the cortical nephrons or the outer part of the cortical nephrons form the peritubular capillaries. While epithelial arteriole of juxtamedullary nephrons, adrenal compassive close to the medulla, it epithelial gives arteriole. The arteriole entity will divide to give capillaries and connect to form VE recti. So, in the medulla, arteriole recti plexus or a group of branch to give capillaries. The capillaries will connect together to form VE recti. The VE recti will deliver blood to arcuate veins. Arcuate veins receive blood from intertubular veins. Receive blood from VE and they give interlobar veins. So, intertubular veins in the cortex collect the blood again from the peritubular capillary plexus, from the kidney capsule, from the outer cortex, and give blood to arcuate veins. Arcuate veins will give blood to interlobular. Enter lower veins and then to outside. Clear the circulation or not clear?
Clear.
Clear. What is the most important in the blood supply of the kidney? It's the arteries are in the arteries. What do you mean by in the artery? No anastomosis. What happens if this artery is blocked by thrombus or bleed? Degeneration in the area supplied by this. This is the most important. Okay? Now, we finish the circulation of blood in the kidney. This is another drawing, but okay. Excretory urinary passages. What are the urinary passages in the kidney? The urinary system. What are the urinary passages? When blood comes out from the apex of the medullary veins, who connects when urine comes out from the apex called Mirarari Benemits. Who collected this urine? Minor cases. Minor cases. From 10 to 18, according to the number of laws. After the minor cases, who will collect the urine from it? Major cases. Each major case collects urine from multiple minor cases. The major cases will deliver urine to the pelvis. And the pelvis will deliver urine to the ureter. And the ureter will send the urine to their bladder when it is stored until you meet urine. Now, what is the structure of the wall of these all urinary passages? Three layers. What are the three layers? Mucosa, muscle layer, and the adventitia. Mucosa, muscle layer, and the adventitia. What is the mucosa? It's formed of two layers. What are the two layers of the mucosa? Epithelium and the connective tissue lamina propria. What is the type of epithelium lining these urinary passages? Transitional tissue. Do these sites can extend with the connection of urine? Yes. So the connective tissue under the epithelium is characterized by fibroelastic. Connective tissue, but contain elastic fiber. Together with collagen. Okay. What is the type of muscle present in the wall? Smooth muscle. Present in which direction? Inner, longitudinal, and outer circular. And if we add a third layer, there will be from outside outer longitudinal. As in the lower part of the ureter. Okay. What is the difference in between the minor and the major and calyx and the ureter? The epithelium becomes thicker and the wall becomes thicker as you go down. One more time. But the same structure. But the epithelium becomes thicker as we go down from minor calyx down to the ureter. The muscle layer or the different layers will thicken more as we go down from the minor calyx to the major calyx. Clear? Clear. And secretory passages convey the urine from the kidney to exterior. It consists of minor and major calyxes, inner pelvis, ureter, urinary bladder, and the primary ureter. The wall of urinary passages is similar in structure, but it decreases gradually in thickness as we go downwards. Each wall is forming of three layers. Mucosa, transitional epithelium, resting on connective tissue, lamina propria, rich in elastic fibers. Musculosa is smooth muscle fibers. Adventitia, connective tissue. I will not speak about transitional epithelium. You know transitional epithelium? Okay. Do the transitional epithelium work as a barrier? Do you hear about an osmotic barrier? Do you hear about osmotic barrier? Do you know? Okay. The urine in the urinary bladder or in the urinary passages is hypertonic. This hypertonic will draw water from the wall of the urinary passages if there is no osmotic barrier. What is the osmotic barrier? It is formed of. It is forming of tight junction between epithelial cells and the surface. And the surface epithelium has a specific structure, makes it
War is an osmotic barrier. Prevents transport of tissue fluid from the tissue of these organs to urine. Simply, when air can come. In a lot, where you can find osmotic barrier? In the epithelium, lining what? Urinary passages. To prevent withdrawal of water from tissue fluid to the cavity of the urinary passages. Alas, when there is the air. ها يوريتا من غير ما نقول وانتوا شفتوه زي يوريتا ها بنارو استلاف شاب اليوم اوكي وول كونسيس اوف ميكوزا ماسكولوزا اند ابيثيشيا ميكوزا ابيثيليا ترانزيشنال ابيثيليا طيب كونكتيف تيشو كوريا كونكتيف تيشو ريتش هي الاستيك فايبرز اوكي دوتا ابيثيليا has two pictures, transitional epithelia has two pictures. Yes. A picture when the bladder is empty and a picture when the bladder is distended. What is the difference between the shape of epithelia in the two states? What is the figure? In the contracted or in the distended full of urine? Contracted 5 to 6 layers. Which of them contain flattened 2 to 3 layers and the other 6 to 8 layers?
Extended 4.
6 to 8 layers in the empty bladder or contracted bladder and 2 to 3 layers in the extended bladder. What is the shape of superficial cells in case of distension?
Squamous.
What is the shape of superficial cells in case of distension?
Squamous.
Flat. What is the shape of superficial cells in case of contraction? Cubical. With convex surface. And the only is that cubical with convex surface it turns into flat. How? What? طيب معلش عارفين الباب القوي؟ في باب لما تلمه يبقى قد كده لما تفرده يتفرد صح؟ طيب السيمبل برين بتاع السوبرفيشال سيلز كده حته تخينه وحته رفيعه تشتغل كمفصله حته تخينه وحته رفيعه حته تخينه وحته رفيعه لما with distension, then it varies. With contraction of the bladder, then it varies. So, the shape of the cell, it changes. This structure too shares in the osmotic barrier. So, the cells are connected by tight junction, which does not allow the passage to be between. Also, the cell membrane of the cells is thick because it has a specific character. That's it. This is a aorta with the star-shaped lumen, the mucosa, the muscle layer, but here the muscle layer is forming of how many layers? Three. So, in the upper two cells of the aorta, the muscle layer is formed of inner longitudinal and outer circular. In the lower cell of the aorta, the muscle layer is present in the form of inner and the outer longitudinal and the embedded circular layer. What is the function of the longitudinal layer here? The circular will constrict, but the longitudinal will dilate and shorten the wall of the ureter. Then, do the urine work by gravity, or it works by contraction of the muscle. It works by contraction of the muscle. And the muscle contraction is severe if there is a stone, because it tries to push the stone out. When the stone closes, a severe pain. When you drink a long amount of water to push the stone and release, the pain will be relieved. And something that the presence of the star-shaped urine helps the urine to pass in these areas, and if there is a small stone or gravity, it will be pushed out. Musculature is formed of smooth muscle fibers arranged at in upper two cells, inner longitudinal, outer circular, lower cell, inner longitudinal, outer longitudinal, and the middle circular layers. Adventitia is the outer layer. This is a section in the bladder and the aorta, urinary bladder. Okay, wall of urinary bladder is thicker than that of the aorta, and its lumen is wide. Because it's folded and formed of epithelium and under the epithelium, connective tissue like the appropriate fibroelastic, والابيثيليوم بتاع الفلابر لنفس التركيب اللي احنا قلناه بس ثيكر. ماسكولوزا It is forming of bundles of smooth muscle fibers which run in different directions. The muscles which connective tissue in between the bundles of muscle fibers. The muscles become arranged in inner longitudinal, outer longitudinal, and the middle circular close to the neck of the bladder. What? The middle circular layer will form at the neck of the bladder. Sphincter. What is the name of this sphincter? Sphincter is present around the inner opening of the urethra. It is formed by thickening of the circular smooth muscles of the bladder. It's this is the internal urethra sphincter. Okay, adventitia forming of fibroelastic connective tissue containing blood vessels, nerves. Okay, the peritoneal surface is covered by fibrosis. We already mentioned that the upper surface of the urinary bladder is covered by serosa. And the bladder descends into the peritoneal cavity if it is full. How many milliliters can be stored by the bladder? 500. Two large cups of water. 500 milliliters. Okay, this is a transitional epithelium in its two states. This is in a contracted state, and this is the epithelium in a distended state. In the distended, 5 to 6 or 8 days. In the distended, 2 to 3 days. In the contracted, 5 to 6 or 8 days. A picture for the epithelium and the wall. Urethra. Okay. The urethra carries urine from the urinary bladder to outside. It has inner end at the bladder and an outer end. What is the structure of the urethra? Fibromuscular tube. Fibro, it contains connective tissue. Muscular, it contains most muscles, but thin. And in two layers. What is the rule in urinary passage? Inner longitudinal and the outer septa. But thin. Do the urethra and the urethra is lined by epithelium? The urethra is lined by epithelium?
Yes,
it is lined by epithelium because we have the septum. Do the urethra give up in males and females? What is the difference in length? Which is longer? The male urethra. Which of them carries the urine? Both. In females, it carries the urine to outside, but in males. A common pathway for urine and sea. Okay? To lubricate the male urethra just before the passage of sea is a gland which secretes mucus to make the movement of semen to outside easier. What are these glands? Bulbourethral glands. Do the female and the male contain a small mucus secreting glands? What are they called? Leprous gland. So, the urethra differ in males and in females. Different in function, different in length, different in structure. Now, this is the female urethra which is short. The female urethra, fibromuscular tube, lined by epithelium. The muscle layer is thin, inner longitudinal and outer septa. What is the type of epithelium in female urethra which is short? What is the type of epithelium?
Transitional.
Third is the urinary bladder, transitional. Third is the external urethral orifice. It has to be similar to the surface, stratified squamous, not creatinine. In the middle area in between, stratified columnar or pseudo stratified columnar. Next, where is there an external urethral sphincter? Formed by what? A skeletal muscle fiber, because it is blank. By skeletal muscle fibers of what? Urogenital diaphragm. By muscles of urogenital diaphragm. What happens to these muscles in old age? Become weaker. Skeletal muscles in old age become weaker. So, there can be incontinence, dribbling of urine with any small pressure. Now, so the female urethra is short. It is lined by transitional pseudostratified columnar, stratified squamous, connective tissue, lamina propria, muscle, inner longitudinal, outer septa, thin, and thin adventitial. Internal urethral sphincter, external urethral sphincter, and I finish. It opens back to the clitoris. Back to the clitoris. Opening of the urethra opens back to the clitoris in female.
What is about the main urethra, which is longer? It is divided into how many parts? How many? Four. Tell me the four. Okay. من كشف الأربعة خليك في الكلام. Okay. What are the three parts? This is the renal bladder and this is the prostate. And this is the start of the urethral opening. The first part passes through the prostate gland. The second part passes through the urogenital diaphragm. The third part passes through the corpus spongiosum. What is the corpus spongiosum? Maybe it contains three corpora. Three corpora. The three corpora, one, two, and three. Two dorsal and one ventral. What is the structure of these three corpora? Erectile tissue. What do we mean by erectile tissue? Rich in blood vessels. What happens to these blood vessels with the stimulation of the autonomic nervous supply by legs? What happens with dilatation of the blood vessels? These corpora become thicker and this strong. This is the erectile tissue. In the ventral corpus, it is called corpus spongiosum. The corpus spongiosum contains the third part of the main urethra. Now, so the main prostatic urethra, which is about 18 to 20 centimeters or 15 to 18 centimeters or 20, it is formed of prostatic urethra, membranous urethra, benign urethra, which open at the apex of the gland speed. It is a fibromuscular tube. What is the lining epithelium of prostatic urethra? That remains, the proximal bundle is lined by what? Transitional epithelium. Okay? The terminal part which opens to the surface is lined by in the dilatation, which is called the fossa navicularis, is lined by what? Stratified squamous non-keratinized DVD. Now, what is about the prostatic urethra? Do the prostatic urethra receive any secretions? What are the types of secretions received by the prostatic urethra?
Alkaline.
What secretion? Do the prostatic urethra receive ejaculatory duct? The ejaculatory duct, one on the right and one on the left. From where the ejaculatory duct gets the secretion?
Vas deferens.
Can it secrete from two areas?
Vas deferens.
Testicular. But coming from the epididymis. From the epididymis to the vas. And go down. Is there another secretion? Seminal vesicles. So the ejaculatory duct carries secretions formed in the testes and stored in the epididymis and goes down through vas deferens. The vas deferens unites with the duct of seminal vesicle and forms ejaculatory duct. We have two, one on the right side and the other on the left side, the ejaculatory duct, the two ejaculatory ducts. Opens into the urethra, the prostatic part of the main urethra. is like the white transitional epithelia. Also, what is the function of the protein? In male, we have a male gland. What is the male gland? Testis. And we have three accessory male glands. What is this male accessory gland? The prostate. Its secretion is carried by ducts into the prostate, together with seminal vesicles, together with pancreatic glands. Male accessory gland, male gland. Because it forms testosterone, together with sperm. I will mention it. The pancreas is a membranous part of the urethra, and it's lined by stratified corona or pseudostratified corona, and it is surrounded by the muscle of urethral diaphragm, which is called external urethral sphincter. Okay, this urethra is lined by stratified corona or pseudostratified corona, and it receives the secretion of pancreatic glands, so the benign part. Present in the corpus callosum. In the penis, it receives the secretion of pancreatin, which is lubricant, its mucus makes the semen go easily to outside. That's it. Thank you.